you go to your doctor to get a checkup. A nurse wraps your arm with a pressure cuff and pumps it up to measure your blood pressure, which is recorded as two numbers, maybe 114 over 74. So far, so good. But what if you want to use that blood pressure reading in a statistical analysis? You can't enter 114 over 74 because it will be treated like a ratio of 150%. We need a single number that is usable for statistics. For this example, we're going to use both Excel and SPSS as we dive deeper into how to solve the tricky problem of isolating the data that we need, computing a new variable with a formula, and then creating a single number called the mean arterial pressure. For this example, we're going to start with some data in Excel. Now, these data come from patient charts, and they represent blood pressure readings for a collection of patients. We're going to isolate the parts of the data that we need, and then use a formula to assemble those parts into a meaningful variable that we can use to measure blood pressure. We are going to accomplish this in three steps. Step one, separate the values in Excel using the left and right commands. Step two, bring that data into SPSS. Step three, calculate a new variable for MAP using the formula. Here is why we are starting this process in Excel. I don't know of any way to do this in SPSS. In Excel, however, we can use the left and right functions to isolate each part of the blood pressure reading. You, of course, recognize these as blood pressure readings, systolic over diastolic. But Excel sees them as ratios, like 1.52%. We want the systolic numbers in one column and the diastolic numbers in a second column, so that we can then use them in the mean arterial pressure formula. Diastolic times 2 plus systolic, all divided by 3. And where did I get this formula? The formula for mean arterial pressure is in most nursing textbooks, or you could find it with a quick internet search. We will begin by creating some new columns labeled SYS for systolic and DIA for diastolic. For the systolic numbers, we will use the left function. The syntax for the left function is this. You first reference the cell that contains the text, followed by the number of characters. The systolic numbers are the first three numbers on the left, so we would type equal sign, left, open parentheses, A2, comma, 3, close parentheses. This creates a cell with the first three numbers on the left end. Highlight the cell and double-click on the handle to copy it to the remaining cells. If all of the diastolic numbers are two digits, then the next part is easy. We simply use the right function to copy only the rightmost two digits into the DIA column. This creates a cell with the two numbers on the right end. Highlight the cell and double-click on the handle to copy it to the remaining cells. In our case, however, we have several blood pressure readings with three diastolic digits. Some have two digits, some have three digits. What can we do? The solution is to improve our diastolic formula. For the diastolic numbers, we will still use the right formula, referencing cell A2. But for the number of values, we have Excel return the entire length of A2 minus everything before the slash using the search function. Double-click to copy down. Left and right functions belong in the category of text functions in Excel. meaning that the result of a left or right formula is always a text string, even if the original values were numbers. Therefore, these numbers are being read as strings, so if you try to do the mean arterial pressure calculations in Excel, you will get an error. That is why, at this point, I import these values into SPSS. After import, SPSS will read the numbers as numeric values and import them that way. But for those of you who are wanting to do this entirely in Excel, you should wrap the left or right functions in the value function, which is designed to convert a string into a number. I am going to save this Excel file to the desktop so that I can import it into SPSS. In SPSS, I go to File, Import Data, Excel. I go to the desktop, select the blood pressure file, and click Open. I click OK in the Import dialog box and the file opens. Notice that both systolic and diastolic numbers have imported as scale data. To create the mean arterial pressure, I will use the compute variable function with a formula. Go to Transform, Compute Variable. I will create a variable called MAP, and for the variable label, I will type Mean Arterial Pressure. The formula for MAP is diastolic times 2 plus systolic, all divided by 3. Click OK. We now have a single number, calculated from blood pressure readings, that we can use for analyzing blood pressure among our respondents.